Good morning. I'm here once again at the Round Mountain Trailhead, and it's a beautiful day. We got really clear blue skies this morning. Hope it stays that way. But we're going to be going for Stone Mountain via the Round Mountain Adventure Trail. And after about 3 minutes, you get to this cutoff, and we want the Summit Trail. The Summit Trail is what's going to take you up to Sheep Mountain and Stone Mountain. That way. Still working my way up the Round Mountain Adventure Trail, and I ran into my first obstacle. This is the problem with winter and early spring hikes, is you get a lot of downed trees in the trail. But it's okay, you just go around it. I'm at the second mile marker. And this is gonna be the first real good view of Stone Mountain. Working my way up to the saddle right there. Then we're gonna hang a left, go over that first hump, and end up at the second one out there. Stone Mountain. I'm about an hour and 40 minutes in, up here at mile marker 3. I'm getting real close to the saddle now. You can see it right up ahead. Then we're going to be cutting to the left. And the good thing is the majority of the elevation gain is done. I'd say most of it is in that first 2.5 miles. We still got a few hundred feet left, but nothing like what we've come up so far. I'd say less than a quarter mile from the 3 mile marker sign, you're going to top out on this saddle right here and look for this cairn and then take the left. And this is going to go over to Stone Mountain right here. Those are some big tracks right there. We're going to follow the animal tracks to the top. I pretty much lost the trail as soon as I got on it. But honestly, I don't think there's much of a trail out here. I think it's more bushwhacking. I mean, there's not really many places to go. Just keep heading up. I can't say I've ever seen a cactus like that before. And they're everywhere out here. I'm on this down and up section. Looks pretty straightforward though. That's going to be the summit right there. And it does look a little dicey at the top. I really like this trail. I can see why people say this is a hidden gem. I don't think it's known about at all. And everybody just comes and does Sheep Mountain, but I don't know. I like this already. We got lots of yucca on the trail. Yucca. Looks like I'm on the main trail again. Summit right there. I might try this side over here. And I'm up here, Stone Mountain Summit. And an amazing view over Loveland there. Got some clouds forming. Back towards Long's Peak and Meeker, and they're in the clouds. And then down to the south. You can see Pike's Peak down there. It's a little hazed out though. What a beautiful day to be on the summit of a mountain. This is amazing. It's a little cloudy, but it's still beautiful out. Still got that nice blue sky. To the east. It's just amazing out here. I highly recommend this hike. This is awesome. So do you guys see why they call this Stone Mountain? When you're looking at it from Loveland, it looks like a big giant pile of rocks. It definitely has a big stone face. This is awesome. And this is one of the best views of Loveland and Fort Collins that I've ever seen. I mean, it's amazing. Is that not the ultimate butt rock or what? Wow. I'm actually excited to sit there and sign the registry. For rad hiking videos, go to Nick Sangetta at YouTube. But you already know that. Looks like I'm about the fourth or fifth person to be up here all year. 7,655 feet. And those blue skies I had when I was hiking up are gone. Clouds are moving in, and they're moving in fast. So it's time to go. Time to head on back. If I could just get on back down there, I'll feel a lot better. You can make that about as hard as you want. But I would say the easiest way up doesn't exceed a minor class 3. There's nothing too bad on that. You can get up it. Ever since those clouds moved in, that hit's dropped about 20 degrees. Once that sun goes away, it gets cold quick. Well, I'll be darned. You don't have to go up and over the big hill. I just did that the first time because I didn't know where the trail was. But if you follow the trail, it stays to the south side and skirts it and does not go up and over. And this is a heck of a lot easier. Wow. Oh well. I gave y'all the deluxe tour. Oh yeah, this is so much easier than going up and over this. Just stay to the south side and you'll be good to go. That rock right there signifies where the main trail junction is. And then you come this way to Stone Mountain. When you get to this point, veer off this way. That's where the trail is. I went this way. That'll take you up and over the hump, which is just as good. It's just a little more bushwhacky. I don't know, in my opinion, going up and over the hill was a more direct, shorter distance than coming around the south side. But it was a pretty nice trail, well-maintained, and pretty flat for the most part. You didn't have to go up and over anything. All right, back at the trail junction. And if you continue on that way, that'll take you to the summit of Sheep Mountain, which is about another mile out, mile back. But you're looking at about another 1,000 feet of gain too, so it's not easy. It literally feels like it lasts forever. That final part just takes forever. I'm taking a final break by this natural spring right here, this little oasis. It's nice to know about this. This is right by the 3 mile marker. So if you ever come to do Sheep Mountain or Stone Mountain, especially in the summer, I mean, this is a hot one. You might want to know where some extra water is. Well, it's right here. Thank you. parking lot's just ahead. Done with the hike. And that was, I'm gonna say, 4 1/4 each way for 8.5 total. And it's a really good hike. Awesome hidden hike no one knows about. I highly recommend it. It's great. Like I said, I was about the 4th person to sign that registry all year. Until the next one, y'all. Peace.